Hello, my name is Cornelius Köln. Today I want to tell you some details and possibilities about the custom user attributes which are new in Privacy IDEA version 3.6. Privacy IDEA is working with something we call user resolvers, which means usually users are already located somewhere, for example here in Active Directory, and Privacy IDEA is configured to read users from this user source, so the users will be available within Privacy IDEA. With all the attributes which are read from the user source. So the user is configured or managed in, for example, Active Directory. The user has attribute A, attribute B, and Privacy IDEA can use these attributes, attribute A, attribute B, to, for example, to define policies or to return these values, for example, in the radius response. Now, what are custom user attributes within Privacy IDEA? The interesting thing is that often the administrator who is responsible for managing the tokens in Privacy IDEA does not have any access to the Active Directory, or the administrator needs information that is not available in Active Directory. What the administrator can do, the administrator can define policies and add custom user attributes to the already existing user. So, using custom user attributes, we can add attribute C, attribute D to this user, and these attributes are managed in Privacy IDEA. So they are added to the user. Or what you can also do is you can even override existing attributes. So you can specify a new value for attribute B. The interesting thing is the administrator can define policies, as mentioned, to allow other admins, help desk users, or even users to manage custom attributes in Privacy IDEA. So, what can you achieve with that? First thing is, you can group users. Imagine you have a lot of different users in your user source, but you want to add an additional tag to the user. And this way you can group the users together in logical groups which do not exist originally in the user source. The other thing you can do, you can overwrite attributes and you can pass these additional attributes to some applications like your firewall or VPN. And you can also allow managing these custom attributes to users, which means the user himself can manage and change existing attributes. Imagine you have a user who should be allowed to change his email address or his phone number. In this video, I will show you how you can do this, how you can allow users to change their attributes, and how help desk users can add a specific attribute to group users together and even choose the value of the attribute from a predefined list. So let's take a look.
Here I am logged in as a super user, and we are looking, in this example, we are looking at the user Cornelius. The user Cornelius is a user that is fetched from Active Directory with certain attributes that are actually read from Active Directory. The user has a simple pass token for simplicity and for testing the custom attributes. Now, when I issue an API authentication request for the user Cornelius, I receive the user attributes read from Active Directory, and these attributes can be used in radius responses to configure your VPN or firewall, and also in policy conditions. Now let's change these attributes, although we do not have, for example, access to Active Directory. To do so, I am configuring a policy for my help desk users. Here I have an admin policy for the help desk users, and let's see what we can do with custom user attributes. We have two policies here, set custom user attributes and delete custom user attributes. Delete custom user attributes is fairly simple. I can specify which attribute keys the help desk user is allowed to delete. Setting the custom user attributes somehow is getting more complicated or flexible. I can set the key department, and since I want to avoid that help desk users are introducing typo to my data, I am defining that the help desk user is only allowed to set the key department to the values sales and development. And in addition, the help desk users are also allowed to set a custom user attribute email. Okay, now let's take a look at the help desk users, how this looks like. The help desk user also sees the user Cornelius fetched from Active Directory. And here we have the important new web UI widget. The help desk user can select, let's first select the department. And as the policy defines specific values for the attribute department, I get a drop down here so that I'm only able to select the specified values, either sales or development. So let's put the user Cornelius in the department sales. Here I can see this is my department. I can delete it again. And the interesting thing now is when Cornelius issues an authentication request, then this custom attribute is added in the response. And this way you can very flexibly add attributes to the response and add it even to radius responses. Now let's take a look what happens when we add an email, a custom email address. You see, this is a combination of all the attributes that are read from Active Directory and the custom attribute we set within Privacy IDEA. Okay, let's say we do not like the email address that is specified in Active Directory, and we would want to change this within Privacy IDEA to BOSS. And here you immediately see that the email address has changed. And again, when we specify or when we issue an authentication request, we also see that the email, which was originally read from Active Directory, is now replaced with the email address, which we specified as custom attributes within Privacy IDEA.
So this screencast, you saw how you can improve the rights and authorization capabilities of Privacy IDEA using the custom attributes. To ease the life of help desk users, we were even able to define an attribute E with predefined values so that you or the administrator was able to help the help desk to only choose predefined values for certain attributes. We think custom user attributes are, again, a rather flexible way to improve your rights and authorization, and I'm sure that you will also find a certain scenario in your setup to use custom user attributes to improve your settings. So thank you for watching and stay tuned.